من الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد فإن الأصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد. After praising Allah Azza wa Jalalahu and sending the peace and blessings upon our beloved Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we would like to welcome you all here today with the greetings of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa alhamd. They wanted me to give a very brief intro concerning the purchase and entering into the, inshallah ta'ala, the new Masjid Ansar As Sunnah. And that is, alhamdulillah, we signed the contracts on Monday and put down the down payment. And so now after this, it's the time for ta'awun and sa'ah, for us to work together and then strive, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, with obtaining the place, it has three classrooms upstairs. Now, where we can start a school for our children. And we have, as where you are sitting now, the musalla for the men, and then there's another musalla upstairs for the women. Above that is a four-bedroom apartment. Then we have the basement area. The masjid itself holds about 400 people. Alhamdulillah, wa alhamd. Outside, there's a 30-car parking lot. And alhamdulillah, we have a good relationship with the county, and they allow us to use the county parking lot across the street. Behind us is a building for janazah, already established, and above that is another apartment. Now, so inshallah ta'ala, with the help of our brothers and sisters and all of us working together, our plan is to establish this dawah to Salafiyah in this area. Now, and call the people around us to it. As Shaykh Dr, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, there are three people who have to be called to this religion. He said the first are the kuffar, who they don't know anything about Islam, they have to be called to Islam. Now, he said the second is the people who aren't upon the minhaj properly. They have to be called. And he said then the third is the group who is upon the proper minhaj, they have to be called away from sin and to be upon that which is correct. So we ask that Allah Azza wa Jal for his help and his assistance, and that inshallah ta'ala all of you see the benefit in trying to attain a house in Jannah, and you aid us and help us. Ameen. Ba'da hadha, with this inshallah ta'ala, without any further ado, I'm going to turn the mic over to our beloved Shaykh Fahad Al Fuhayd. Alhamdulillah, who his job is that he oversees the Kuliyah of Deen in Riyadh at Muhammad ibn Saud. Alhamdulillah, wa la alhamd, fa atafandun.
Jazakallah bi khair. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, fa inni ahmadullah wa ashkuruhu jalla wa ala an yassara hadha al-liqa fi hadha al-masjid al-mubarak, Masjid Ansar As Sunnah, fi New Jersey. في يوم الجمعة ليلة السبت 25 من شهر شعبان من عام 36,400 من الهجرة النبوية.
The Sheikh, after praising Allah, the Sheikh said, after praising Allah, sending peace and blessings upon our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about for being here this day in Masjid Ansar As Sunnah in New Jersey, and that on the night of the 25th night of Sha'ban, on this night of Jumu'ah, which is the first night of Saturday, And he said, Allah Ta'ala, we praise him and thank him for being here with you brothers. Naam tafaddal.
ونظرا لأن الوقت إلى صلاة العشاء ساعة فنرجو يعني أن نذكر كثيرا من الأحكام والآداب المتعلقة بشهر رمضان المبارك.
The Shaykh said he's going to, you know, try to, in spite of looking at the time, which is short, which is basically an hour to Jumta of Isha, he said, I'm going to try my best to cover as quickly as possible the legal verdicts and the etiquettes and manners related to the month of Ramadan.
فنبدأ على بركة الله فنقول إن الله سبحانه وتعالى امتن على عباده بمنن ونعم لا تعد ولا تحصى.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we say we're going to begin, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us and put much bounties that He bestowed upon us for this noble month of Ramadan.
وعلمهم جل وعلا كيف يعبدونه حق عبادته.
And He bestowed upon us the bounty of worship, and He showed His servants how they must single Him out alone for worship and worship Allah.
وبماذا يتدينون من الأديان.
And that what the believers must do of practicing religion.
فقال تعالى.
Allah Ta'ala says.
ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه.
That Allah Ta'ala says, whoever desires a religion other than Islam, it will never be accepted from them.
وقال تعالى. كما أرسلنا فيكم رسولا منكم يتلو عليكم آياتنا.
Just as Allah Ta'ala says, just as we have sent a messenger from amongst you who will recite upon you our verses.
ويزكيكم ويعلمكم الكتاب والحكمة.
And He will purify you and teach you the book.
ويعلمكم ما لم تكونوا تعلمون.
He will teach you the book and the wisdom, which is the sunnah, and He will teach you that which you do not know.
فلولا فضل الله علينا لكنا في عماية وفي جهالة عظيمة.
If it wasn't for the fact of the bounty of Allah being upon us, we truly would be upon blindness and misguidance.
فالحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام.
All praise is due to Allah, the one who has guided us to Islam.
ونسأل الله أن يثبتنا على الإسلام والسنة.
We ask Allah to keep us firm upon the Islam and the Sunnah.
ومما علمنا الله عز وجل أن هذا الإسلام مبني على خمسة أركان.
From the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us is that Islam is based upon five pillars.
فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج بيت الله الحرام لمن استطاع إليه سبيلا.
And the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم has testified to this when he said Islam is built upon five. The testimony that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to establish the salah, and to pay the zakah, and to give the pay the zakah, and to make hajj to the house, whoever is able to do so.
وَقَدْ أَظَلَّنَا وَقَرُبَ نُزُولُ ضَيْفٍ كَرِيمٍ وَمُوسِمٍ عَظِيمٍ أَلَا وَهُوَ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الْمُبَارَكِ.
And I forgot to mention the Shaykh said fasting the month of Ramadan. And he said, one of the virtues of this particular month that Allah has bestowed us upon us the bounty to be able to take advantage of this month.
وَهُوَ مِنْ أَعْظَمِ أَسْبَابِ مَغْفِرَةِ الذُّنُوبِ.
And this month is from the greatest means for us to obtain forgiveness of our sins.
فَفِي صَحِيحِ الْبُخَارِ وَمُسْلِمْ عَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانْ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه.
From that is the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said that whoever fasts the month of Ramadan, believing in his obligation and seeking a reward from Allah, Allah will forgive for him that which preceded of his sins.
ومن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه.
In another version of this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever stands in prayer in Ramadan and believing in his obligation, hoping for, seeking a reward and hoping for a reward from Allah, it will be forgiven for him what has preceded of his sins.
وَمَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ.
And another version, that whoever stands on the night of decrees, that Allah, he will, believing in his obligation and hoping for a reward, also will be forgiven for him what has preceded of his sins.
فَالصَّوْمُ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا سَبَبٌ لِمَغْفِرَةِ الذُّنُوبِ.
So fasting, what believing in this obligation and hoping in a reward, is the cause of getting sins forgiven.
وَقِيَامُ رَمَضَانَ سَبَبٌ آخَرُ أَيْضًا.
And standing in the prayer of Ramadan also is another means of getting sins forgiven.
وَقِيَامُ لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ الَّتِي مَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانَ سَيَقُومُهَا بِلَا رَيْبٍ سَبَبٌ ثَالِثٌ مِنْ أَسْبَابِ مَغْفِرَةِ الذُّنُوبِ.
Also, standing in the night of Laylatul Qadr is also, in prayer, is also the third reason for getting the sins, for causing the sins to be forgiven.
فَاجْتَمَعَتْ هَذِهِ الْأَسْبَابُ الثَّلَاثَةُ لِتَكْفِيرِ الذُّنُوبِ وَالْخَطَايَا.
And the gathering of these three things are from the means of expiating of sins and mistakes that we make.
وَلِهَذَا سُمِعَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ سَمِعَ الصَّحَابَةَ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ آمين ثم قال آمين ثم قال آمين فسأل الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أسباب هذا.
That for this reason the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions heard him say one day آمين أو الله accept وآمين أو الله accept آمين أو الله accept. So then the companions asked the Prophet, what was the reason for this?
فقال إن جبريل عليه السلام قال يا محمد من أدرك رمضان ثم خرج ولم يغفر له فأبعده الله قل آمين فقلت آمين.
He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said to me that whoever reaches Ramadan and enters it and leaves out of the month of Ramadan and he's not forgiven, have not received forgiveness, may Allah keep him distant and far away.
يعني أن أسباب المغفرة قد اجتمعت له وأعرض عنها فهذا قد أبعده الله.
And so for what happened, the reason for that is he has become gathered for him in this month the three reasons for obtaining the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he didn't take advantage of that, so Allah kept him distant, so Allah keep him distant and far away from forgiveness and mercy.
وذكر في التأمين الثاني والثالث وذكر في التأمين الثاني والثالث ذكر في التأمين الثاني قال أن جبريل عليه السلام قال من أدرك أبوي أو أحدهما عند الكبر فلم يدخلاه الجنة فأبعده الله قل آمين فقلت آمين.
And I forgot to mention when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned to them what Jibril has said. Jibril told him to say Ameen, and the Prophet said, told the companion, say Ameen. So they said Ameen. He said the second reason he said Ameen, the Prophet went to explain to his companions, is that a person who has two parents, and his parents reach old age, and they didn't cause him to enter the paradise, may Allah keep him distant from his forgiveness. So say Ameen. And so the companion said Ameen.
وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ بِرَّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ من أعظم أسباب دخول الجنة ومغفرة الذنوب.
This is because being dutiful and good to your parents are from the reasons and causes of getting sins expiated and forgiven.
فمن وفقه الله فأدرك أبويه فلم يقم بهذا فأبعده الله.
So whoever reached his two parents old age and he didn't take advantage of that and caused him to enter the paradise, may Allah keep him distant from his forgiveness and mercy.
وأما التأمين الثالث فهو لما قال جبريل عليه الصلاة والسلام للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من ذكرت عنده فلم يصلي عليك فأبعده الله فقل آمين فقلت آمين اللهم صل وسلم على النبي محمد.
He said the third Ameen was for the reason, as he explained to his companions, that whoever reaches him, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying of صلى الله عليه وسلم of upon him, and he hears this and he doesn't send present for, sends the taslim upon the Prophet, may Allah distance him from his forgiveness. So say Ameen, Ameen. And he told that to the companions and he sent prayers and peace and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وجاء في الصحيحين أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا دخل رمضان فتحت أبواب الجنة وغلقت أبواب الجحيم وسلسلة الشياطين.
He said that also in Sahih Bukhari or Muslim, agreed upon by Bukhari and Muslim, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that when the month of Ramadan enters, that the gates of paradise are all open and the gates of hell are all locked and the shayateen are locked up or in fetters.
وذلك أن كثرة الأعمال الصالحة تفتح لأجلها أبواب الجنة اشتياقا لأهلها. نسأل الله جعلنا وإياكم من أهل الأعمال الصالحة.
آمين. The reason for that, this happened in the month of Ramadan, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He opened the door for the ability for many righteous deeds to be achieved and done in this month. And that the righteous deeds in this month are desiring them to be practiced and implemented. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to do that.
وكذلك هذا الشهر الكريم من أسباب عتق العبد من النار.
This noble month also is from the means of us being able to rescue ourselves or free ourselves from being in the hellfire.
وكذلك تصفد الشياطين ومردة الجن.
For that reason, the shayateen have been chained up, and the mischief makers from amongst the jinn and the shayateen.
يقول عليه الصلاة والسلام في الحديث الآخر فلا تصل إلى ما كانت تصل إليه من قبل. فلا تصل إلى ما كانت تصل إليه من قبل. يعني أن نشاطها وشرها يقل في هذا الشهر الكريم لا أنه ينقطع بالكلية.
He said what's going on here in this description of the shayateen being locked up, that the reason is because what they were able to reach and achieve of causing evil and corruption has been decreased for them in the month of Ramadan, but it hasn't been cut off in totality.
ولهذا شياطين الإنس وشياطين الجن لا يزال شرهم مستمرا.
For that reason, we still find that the evil of the shayateen, the devils from amongst mankind and jinnkind, is still continuous even in this month.
لكن في رمضان وبسبب هذا الشهر الكريم والصيام يقل شر الشيطان على المسلم.
For that reason, because we find when the month of Ramadan has come, his evilness has been decreased and lessened because of this month of Ramadan and putting this bounty upon us to do the good.
ومن فضائل هذا الشهر الكريم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال فيه الصيام جنة فإذا كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يسخط فإن سابه أحد أو قاتله فليقل إني امرئ صائم.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
نعم الصيام جنة يعني حماية ووقاية للمسلم.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, for this reason, he said fasting is a shield and a protection. So whoever comes and insults you and or attacks you verbally, then that individual should say to that person, I'm fasting. So for this reason, in the month, the Prophet ﷺ, and I'm proceeding something from the hadith, that the Prophet also said in this hadith that a person should not get involved in arguing and yelling and fighting and foul mouth and evil statement and abominable statements. No.
ومن فضائل إدراك شهر رمضان ما جاء في مسند الإمام أحمد وغيره أن ثلاثة من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اثنان منهم استشهد والثالث أدرك شهر رمضان.
That one of them, the hadith that comes in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked about three men, that two of them had died as martyrs and one of them lived till he reached the month of Ramadan. No.
فالاثنان قد استشهدا يعني قاتلا في سبيل الله فقتلا والثالث مات في فراشه.
He said, and as far as the two who died as martyrs, they died fighting in the path of Allah to the point they were martyrs in the deen of Islam. And as for the third one who reached Ramadan, he wound up dying in his bed. And the Messenger of Allah talked about these three men.
فرؤية في المنام متقدما عليهما رؤية المتأخر في الوفاة الذي أدرك رمضان متقدما عليهما.
And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had narrated, it was narrated that the man who died in his bed had preceded, when he died after the two who died as martyrs, the third one had preceded the other two who died as martyrs in entering paradise.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أليس صلى بعدهما كذا وكذا صلاة وَأَدْرَكَ شَهْرَ رَمَضَانَ.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was explaining now, just to be clear, those three men had died, two of them died as martyrs. So they died before the third man who reached Ramadan, and he later on in his life died in his bed. And so, later on died in his bed. And what had happened, the Messenger of Allah was asked, how can this man precede the martyrs in entering paradise? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained, is not his case that this man reached the month of Ramadan? Is not the case that this man, he had prayed so many more raka'ats of prayer, which was a year length of time more than those two martyrs who died of prayer. A year's worth of raka'ats of prayer.
ولهذا إدراك هذا الشهر وصيامه وقيامه وإيمانه واحتسابا من أعظم المنن والنعم على العبد المسلم.
So for this reason, we abstract from this, that from the greatest bounties and that's bestowed upon us is that a person reached this month of Ramadan. For just the fact that man reached Ramadan caused him to precede them, the martyrs, in entering paradise.
ومن فضائل هذا الشهر أن الله عز وجل جعل بابا من أبواب الجنة للصائمين يدعى باب الريان لا يدخل منه إلا الصائمون من فضلهم ومكانتهم وشرفهم وتقديرهم.
That the Shaykh said also from the virtues and bounties of the month of Ramadan is that from the doors of paradise, there's a door that's specifically been made for the fasting people called Ar-Rayyan. And this door is specifically for them and no one will enter it but them. And once they enter it, it will be locked. And he said this is because of the nobility of them fasting and in the honor that had they achieved and Allah raising their ranks for this reason.
ومن فضائل الصيام أيضا أنه من أسباب حصول الشفاعة له يوم القيامة.
From also the bounties of this month is that those who fast in this month, that fasting becomes a shield and become will be an intercessor for them on the day of judgment.
ففي الحديث الصحيح يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة.
From among, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that fasting and the Quran, both of them will intercede on behalf of the one who fasted and recited the Quran.
يقول الصوم ربي منعته الطعام والشراب بالنهار فشفعني فيه.
And fasting will say and speak to Allah on his behalf, saying, "Oh my Lord, I hindered this man from his food and his drink and intimacy. So allow me to intercede on his behalf."
ويقول القرآن ربي منعته ويقول القرآن منعته النوم في الليل فشفعني فيه.
And the Quran will say, "Oh my Lord, I hindered this individual from sleeping at night because he got up and prayed with me. So allow me to intercede on his behalf."
والمراد هنا ثواب الصيام وثواب قراءة القرآن.
And the point from both of these narrations of these type of intercession is the virtue and the reward that is obtained from fasting and reciting the Quran.
وننتقل بعد هذا إلى ذكر بعض حكم الصيام.
For this reason now, we will move on from that issue to mentioning some of the
حكم.
Of some of the wisdoms of why we fast.
No. فهل الحكمة من الصيام مجرد الجوع والعطش؟
That the wisdom behind fasting isn't the fact of just being thirsty and hungry.
الجواب قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
Okay, let me correct that. The Sheikh said as a question to everyone, or as a question, a rhetorical question, he said, is the point of fasting just to be hungry and thirsty? He said the answer to that is what Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, O you who believe, has been prescribed upon you fasting as it was prescribed on those before you, so that you may obtain taqwa.
إذن الحكمة من الصيام هي تقوى الله عز وجل.
So therefore the wisdom behind fasting is to obtain taqwa, fearing Allah عز وجل.
وما هي التقوى؟
So what is taqwa?
التقوى أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله.
That taqwa, it is
أن تعمل
is to do deeds, to implement and practice the obedience of Allah upon light and guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ترجو ثواب الله.
Hoping for the reward of Allah azza wa jal.
وأن تترك معصية الله.
And to abandon the acts of disobedience of Allah
على نور من الله.
From a light and guidance from Allah.
تخشى عقاب الله.
While fearing the chastisement and punishment of Allah.
فالتقوى أن تجعل بينك وبين النار وقاية.
And taqwa is nothing more that you make between you and the hellfire a barrier that protects you from it.
وما بيننا وبين الله نسب.
There's no leanage between us and Allah.
فمن اتقى الله وأطاعه أدخله الله الجنة.
So therefore the one who fears Allah and obedient to Allah, that Allah will enter him into the paradise.
ومن عصى الله وكفر به أدخله الله النار.
And whoever disobeys Allah and disbelieves and rejects his commandments and prohibitions, then Allah will enter him into the hellfire.
فالتقوى هي الوسيلة للنجاة يوم القيامة.
That taqwa is a means for having safety and security on the day of judgment.
والحكمة من الصوم في شهر رمضان أن نتعلم التقوى.
And the wisdom behind the month of Ramadan is that we learn what taqwa is and obtain it. Because fasting is a secret hidden thing. No one knows that you're doing it except for Allah Azza wa
Jal.
It is a secret relationship between the servant and his Lord.
لو اختفى عن الناس وأكل لم يعلم به أحد.
If he go and hide himself away from the people and ate, no one will know about that.
ولكن المؤمن يترك الطعام والشراب خوفا من الله.
But the mu'min, the true believer, leaves off food and drink, fearing from Allah Azza wa Jalla.
ويترك الطعام والشراب رجاء في ثواب الله عز وجل.
He leaves off food and drink, hoping for a reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla.
وهذا يعلمه أن يترك جميع المعاصي كلها خوفا من الله.
And what that teaches the believer, the importance of why he must leave off all acts of disobedience to Allah Azza wa Jalla.
وأن يفعل الواجبات والطاعات رجاء ثواب الله عز وجل.
And it teaches him that he must do the acts, the obligations, and the acts of obedience, hoping for a reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla.
فالصوم مدرسة للتقوى.
So therefore, fasting is a teacher, a school for obtaining how to obtain taqwa.
ولهذا من حكم الصيام أيضا أن يربي المسلم نفسه على طاعة الله ورسوله.
So from the wisdom also of fasting is that the servant, this of Allah, he cultivate himself upon this taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla and grows it within himself.
وألا يتبع الشهوات.
And that he learns how not to follow his own desires.
فكلنا نشتهي أن نشرب الماء إذا عطشنا.
All of us want to drink water when we desire it.
ونشتهي أن نأكل متى ما جعنا.
And all of us desire to eat when we're hungry.
فنترك ذلك من طلوع الفجر إلى غروب الشمس طاعة لله.
But however we leave that from the dawn of Fajr, to the appearance of Fajr until the setting of the sun, all for the sake of fearing Allah and obtaining His taqwa.
فماذا نجد عند الإفطار?
So what we find within ourselves at the time we break our fast?
كلكم كل واحد منكم كل مسلم يجد ما أخبر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الفرحة.
That what we find, all of us, every believer, he finds at the time that he breaks his fast what the Messenger of Allah said that every believer finds. Happiness and rejoice.
حيث قال عليه الصلاة والسلام للصائم فرحتان.
Whereas the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, for the believer are two rejoices.
فرحة عند فطره.
The rejoice at the time of him breaking his fast or breaking his fast.
وفرحة عند لقاء ربه.
And the rejoice with the time when he go meets his Lord.
وهذا يعلمك أن اتباع الشهوات لا منفعة فيه.
This shows us nothing more than following one's whims and desires, there's no benefit in it.
وأن قهر النفس على الطاعة هو الذي ينفعك.
And forcing discipline yourself upon obedience, that is the thing that benefits you.
وهذا من بيان فوائد العبادات كلها.
Oh, this basically does nothing more than clarifies the benefits of worship in totality.
ولهذا نقول الحكمة العظمى من الصيام تحقيق عبادة الله وحده لا شريك له.
Therefore we say that the greatest benefit that we take out of our fasting is the benefit of obedience to Allah and taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla.
لأننا خلقنا لنعبد الله عز وجل.
Because we were only created to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla.
وننبه على بعض الأشياء التي قد يغفل عنها بعض إخواننا.
And we will bring attention to some things that many of our brothers are heedless to.
وهي أنهم يذكرون في هذا المقام مسألة الصحة للجسم.
That many of us tend to think when we're in a situation of fasting, what runs of our mind, what's going to be the case of my health when I'm fasting?
وأن الفائدة من الصوم هي صحة الجسم.
But we say and think that the benefit we get in from the fasting is that it benefits our health.
قد يكون هذا صحيحاً.
This perhaps can be something that's correct.
ولكن الحكمة من الصوم أعظم من ذلك بكثير.
But however, the wisdom behind fasting is tremendously greater than that.
والحكمة من الصلاة والحكمة من الزكاة والحكمة من الحج هو أن نعبد الله وحده.
That the wisdom of fasting, the wisdom of praying, the wisdom of giving zakat is the benefit of worshiping Allah alone by Himself.
فليست الغاية من خلقنا صحة أجسامنا.
But it is not the purpose of our creation is to have good health.
وإنما الغاية من خلقنا أن نعبد ربنا.
But the purpose of our creation is to worship our Lord alone.
وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
I have not created jinkind or mankind for no purpose except to worship me alone.
يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم.
O mankind, worship your Lord.
وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء.
And they have not been ordered with nothing more than that they must single out Allah alone for worship and be حنفاء, completely turned to Allah and turning away from anything else other than Allah.
وفي الصوم من الفوائد ما الله به عليم.
He said, for therefore from the benefits of fasting is that which Allah knows best.
فأنت تذكر عندما لا تأكل ولا تشرب حال إخوانك الفقراء والمحاويج.
He said you are grateful and we realizing when you're fasting the state and condition of your brothers who are hungry and starving.
فأنت تأكل وتشرب متى ما اشتهيت.
You are able to fast and eat and drink. You're able to eat and drink whenever you desire.
فتنسى معاناة الفقراء.
Which can lead you to forget the hardships of the poor.
وتنسى معاناة الذين أصابتهم الكوارث والمصائب العظيمة.
And you can tend to, because of this ease, to forget the catastrophes and the hardships that befall others.
ولهذا تربي نفسك على الإحسان للفقراء والمساكين.
So your means of fasting is the way to cultivate yourself to be conscious and remember the state of these poor people, people going through catastrophes.
فعن عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس.
For this reason, Abdullah ibn Abbas said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most kindest and generous of the people.
وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان.
And the time that he was most generous and most kind was in Ramadan.
حين يلقاه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن.
Specifically at the time when Jibril would meet with him and teach him the Quran and study and teach with him the Quran.
فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة.
So for this reason, it was said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was more generous and more kind than a quick wind or sent wind.
الريح المرسلة, الريح التي تحمل السحب التي فيها الماء والمطر والخير للأرض.
And the quick wind is the wind that is mentioned here is the wind that carries the clouds that have rain and benefit and mercy.
والمطر إذا نزل وهو كان مطرا عاما هل يخص أرضا دون أرض أم يعمها كلها.
He said, so when a cloud comes with rain and it drops the rain, does the rain specifies an area or does it drops the rain and benefit of the whole area.
فهكذا كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيره يعم الناس كلهم.
And like this was the Messenger of Allah, is what this hadith is describing, is that his kindness and generosity encompass all of the believers.
للفقراء والمحاويج.
For the poor and those in dire need.
وللأرامل والمساكين.
And for widows and poor people.
وحتى الأغنياء يصيبهم من خيره ونفعه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Even to the point, even the rich people benefited from the Prophet's goodness.
فكان بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم عليه الصلاة والسلام.
As Allah Ta'ala said about him, he was with the believers kind and mercy and courteous.
فالمقصود أيها الإخوة الكرام أن هذا الشهر فيه منافع عظيمة جداً جداً جداً.
So the point and purpose here, oh my brothers, is that the month of Ramadan in it is an abundancy of goodness, abundancy, abundancy, abundancy.
لا مثل له.
There's nothing like it.
من الأعمال الصالحة.
From the righteous deeds.
يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم says.
كل عمل ابن آدم له العشرة الحسنة بعشر أمثالها.
That every deed is for the servant he get 10 rewards, 10 like rewards of that one deed. Up until 700 multiples. And Allah went on to say in this hadith Qudsi, except for fasting.
فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ
But the Allah says the fasting is for me, and I will reward him for that.
يقول الله تكمل الحديث يدع طعامه وشرابه وشهوته من أجلي.
And completing the rest of the hadith, Allah Ta'ala says, he has left off his food and his drink for my sake.
من أجلي يدع طعامه وشرابه وشهوته من أجلي.
The Shaykh said, repeated the hadith because I forgot something in the hadith. The Prophet, Allah Ta'ala says in this hadith Qudsi, my servant for my sake left off his food, his drink, and his desires. I left out desires. He repeated it. Look at the wisdom of Shaykh without telling me. Manners, brothers.
فهذا يبين لك أخي الكريم منزلة الصوم عند الله سبحانه وتعالى وأن الله عز وجل يجعل المؤمن الصائم له مكانة عظيمة عنده.
This clarifies for us, O my noble brothers, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى has a tremendous reward, a specific reward only for the believers that we should take advantage of.
ويكفي شرفا للصائم قول الله عز وجل في الحديث السابق الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به.
He said sufficient enough as a virtue and a benefit, the simple fact of what Allah says in this hadith Qudsi that we mentioned previously, that fasting, he fasts for me and I'm going to reward him for it. Sufficient enough as a benefit, fasting is that alone.
يعني أن الصوم قد اختص الله عز وجل بمجازات أهله وإعطائهم الثواب العظيم الذي لا يمكن حصره.
He said in this point here, what it means in a statement of Allah, he fasted, and for me, and I will reward him. Meaning that this reward is endless. It's not like the hadith he mentioned before, where everyone who does a good deed, it get 10 manifolds up to 700 multiples, up to many multiples. He said, this is different from that. This here, Allah is saying he's going to reward you for it. He's going to reward you, this reward is endless.
الصوم من الصبر.
Fasting is from patience.
لأنه صبر. على طاعة الله وصبر بترك معاصي الله وصبر على الألم.
He said the patience that is required here in the for fasting is the patience of leaving off what displeases Allah and
obedience.
وترك الحرام. The patience of making yourself being obedient and the patience of making yourself leave off that which is haram.
والصبر على المصيبة والألم.
And the patience that is required to deal with the pain that comes with your fasting.
وخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك. خلوف الرائحة الكريهة التي تخرج من الفم نتيجة عن خلو المعدة.
That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had mentioned that the inner mouth down to the chest area, the mouth down to the chest, this area, the smell that comes up, the bad smell that comes from it, Allah's Messenger made clear that to Allah is like the smell of musk. It's like the smell of musk.
هذه بعض آداب أو بعض فضائل هذا الشهر الكريم.
And this is some of the virtues and benefits of this blessed month, this noble month.
وبعض الحكم والفوائد من صيام شهر رمضان.
And these are some of the wisdoms and some of the benefits of the month of Ramadan.
وننتقل بعد هذا إلى الإشارة إلى بعض الأحكام الفقهية المتعلقة بهذا الشهر الكريم.
Now we will move on from that to talk about some of the legal verdicts connected to this noble month.
أولا الصيام تعريفه هو الإمساك بنية عن المفطرات.
He said that fasting, and he giving you the legislative meaning of it, it is to refrain with the intentions, to refrain from that which will break your fast, with the intentions of worshiping Allah.
من طلوع الفجر الصادق إلى غروب الشمس.
Until the appearance of the true dawn, until the sun sets.
ويجب تبييت النية في الصيام.
Now, it is obligatory that one must spend the night making his intentions present for fasting the next day. It's not that you utter it off of your tongue. You don't make talaffuz, you don't utter this off of your tongue, your intentions, but it's something you do within your heart.
لحديث حفصة رضي الله عنها.
Because of the hadith of حفصة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
من لم يبيت الصيام من الليل فلا صيام له.
Whoever doesn't spend the night making the intentions for fasting, there's no fasting for him the next day.
فلنفرض مثلا أن غدا رمضان مثلا.
He said, for example, we're going to give an example. A person want to fast.
فأنت الآن تعتقد أن غدا يوم صوم.
And you got the idea in your mind, tomorrow is the month of Ramadan.
هذه هي النية.
This is what is meant by your intentions.
ما يحتاج أن تتكلف تقول نويت أن أصوم غدا هذا غير مشروع.
It doesn't mean here that you say I'm going and you burden yourself and say I have the intentions to fast the month of Ramadan tomorrow. No, this has not been legislated to do.
ولكننا نستفيد من هذا.
But however, we benefit from this.
أن من بلغه دخول الشهر متأخرا.
That whoever has reached him, that Ramadan has come, when he found out late.
فإنه يمسك حين بلوغه الخبر.
But what's upon him at that point is he start fasting soon as the news reached him that Ramadan has entered.
ويقضي يومه ذلك.
And then he makes that particular day up, even though he begin fasting. So what the Shaykh is saying, if you, for example, during the day, Ramadan hits, you didn't know, you ate something or whatever, and then you did eat something, but you in the morning during the day and you find out, it reaches you, Ramadan starts. It's wajib upon you to begin your fast at that point, but you have to make that day up after Ramadan is over. So you still fast it, but yet you got to make it up. Because you didn't, it was unable to reach you during the night.
ويمسك لقوله تعالى فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم.
And the proof that the individual begins his refraining at the moment he hears the news is the statement of Allah that whoever witnessed this month, then he must fast it. فليصمه. He must fast it.
ويقضي لأنه لم يتم صومه بنية.
And the reason being that he has to make up the day after Ramadan is because he didn't spend that night making the intentions.
وكذلك مما يتعلق بموضوع النية.
Likewise, of the things that is connected to the issue of intentions,
من فقد عقله.
Is the one who lost his sanity.
كالإغماء.
Like, for example, he fell unconscious.
وكذلك البنج. الذي يعطى في المستشفى المخدر المنوم.
He said, or for example, a person who's been given some like a needle or some type of medication that caused him to lose his intelligence because he's sick in the hospital. This is another example of that.
فمن استغرق غياب عقله يوما كاملا يوم النهار كله فهذا يقضي.
He says, so this person who lost his sanity, his reasoning, because of those reasons he mentioned and other reasons, and it lasts to the whole day of the day of fast, the time of fasting of that whole day, then it's upon him to make it up after Ramadan that particular day.
وكذلك المغمى عليه يقضي.
Likewise, the person who fainted and passed out, he got to make up the time because he don't know what happened in the time of being unconscious.
أما النائم فلا يقضي.
As for the person who is asleep, he don't have to make it up.
لأن عقله معه.
Because his sanity was with him while he was asleep, in comparison to the person who was unconscious, put to sleep.
وكذلك من الأحكام المتعلقة بهذا الشهر إذا أسلم الكافر في نهار رمضان.
Another thing that's connected to the legal verdicts of Ramadan is a non-Muslim who accepts Islam during the daytime of Ramadan.
فإنه يمسك من حين إسلامه.
That he must, at the moment he says the shahada, refrain and begin fasting.
ولا يجب عليه قضاء ذلك اليوم ولا ما قبله من الأيام.
And it's not upon him to make up that day, nor the days that he missed before his Islam.
ولكن يمسك من حين إسلامه ويصوم بقية الأيام.
But what he does, he begins fasting the moment he takes his shahada and the rest of the month of Ramadan.
وكذلك من أحكام الصيام ما يتعلق ب البلوغ أو التكليف الذي يجمع بين العقل والبلوغ.
From the, also the connecting issues to the legal verdicts to Ramadan is reaching the age of puberty.
فالصبي لا يجب عليه الصوم.
The one who hasn't reached the age of purity from the young boys and girls is not obligatory upon them to fast.
لكن يستحب أن يعود الصيام إذا أطاقه.
He said, but what is recommended, highly recommended, is that child be trained and disciplined on how to fast if he has that capability or she.
وكان الصحابة رضي الله عنهم يعودون صغارهم الصيام.
Because the companions used to accustom their young ones to fasting.
فإذا جاعوا أعطوهم اللعب يتلهون بها.
And when they became hungry, they would give them toys to play with to distract them from eating.
حتى إذا بلغ سن الرشد وجاءه رمضان صار سهلا عليه.
So that the fact they got accustomed of doing this to their children, getting them accustomed to fasting, so that when they do reach the age of puberty, fasting will become easy for them because they're used to it.
لكن الذي لا يطيق الصيام ويضره فلا يصوم من الصبي.
As for those children who don't have the ability to fast and it's very difficult upon them or a hardship on them, it's not upon them to be trained to fast.
وكذلك المجنون الذي جنونه مطبق دائما هذا لا صيام عليه.
Likewise, the person who lost his sanity permanently, it's not upon them to fast, it's lifted from them.
ومن كان يفيق احيانا ويجن احيانا.
As for the one who has his sanity sometimes and he's insane sometimes.
فإذا أفاق وعقل يؤمر بالإمساك.
When at the times when he does have the state of sanity, he's ordered to fast.
لكن لا يجب عليه القضاء.
But it's not obligatory for him to make up when he was in a state of insanity to make it up when he's in a state of sanity.
ومن أحكام الصيام ما يتعلق بالشيخ الكبير والعجوز الكبيرة اللذان يعجزان عن الصوم.
From the legal verdicts connected to fasting is regards to the elderly man and the elderly woman. It is not obligatory for them to fast.
قال الله تعالى وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين.
Allah, for the proof is the statement of Allah تعالى, and upon those who find difficulty in fasting, that they don't have to fast.
فالشيخ الكبير والعجوز الكبيرة إذا عجز عن الصوم فإنهما يفطران ويطعمان عن كل يوم مسكينا.
And Allah Ta'ala made clear in this verse, it is upon them to give the fidya, which is a ransom, which is feeding a poor person for those days that they come for them not being able to fast. And this is what they do in place of fasting.
والإطعام من أوسط ما يطعم أهلنا.
And of course, it is the most easiest of food that we feed our people with.
وذلك عند أهل العلم يقدر بقوت البلد.
He said, according to the scholars of Islam, that amount of food is based according to the food stuff of the people of your country.
وهو بالكيلوغرام تقريبا كيلوين ونصف من الأرز أو الدخن أو الذرة أو حسب ما يكون في البلد.
He said, for example, like a kilo and a half or a kilo of food stuff, like corn, rice, and things of this nature, or that which is the foodstuff of the people of your country.
ويكون معه إدام من لحم أو زيت. هذا هو يعني قوت البلد أو هذا هو الذي نطعمه أهلنا.
He said, even if it be the type of food that could become destroyed, like meat and things of this nature, he said, if that's the food of the people of your country, that can be the thing that's used.
وفي صحيح البخاري أن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه لما كبرت سنه وعجز عن الصوم.
That Anas ibn Malik, it comes in Sahihain,
Sahih Bukhari,
that Anas ibn Malik, when he became an old man,
كان في نهاية شهر رمضان,
that he would, at the end of the month of Ramadan,
يجمع مساكين بعدد تلك الأيام,
that he would add and he would gather the poor in according to the number of days of that Ramadan,
ويطعمهم,
and he would feed them at one time.
فهذا هو فدية من عجز عن الصوم.
And this is the ransoming for the one who's unable to fast.
لكبر سنه.
Because of his old age.
وكذلك من الأحكام المتعلقة.
Likewise from the legal verdicts that's connected to fasting.
بالشهر رمضان موضوع الحائض والنفساء.
For the month of Ramadan is the situation of the woman who's in her menses or having postpartum bleeding.
فالحائض والنفساء لا يصح منهما صوم رمضان.
As far as the menstruating woman and the postpartum bleeding woman, it is not correct for her to fast.
ولو صام لم يقبل منهما.
And if she was to fast, it will not be accepted from her by Allah.
فإذا طهرت الحائض والنفساء
and once she become purified from her menses or postpartum bleeding
وجب عليهما الإمساك
upon the both of them to start fasting
ويقضيان ما أفطراه في تلك الأيام أيام الحيض والنفاس
and they make up after Ramadan the days that they miss while they're on their menses or postpartum bleeding
ما يتعلق بأحكام وجوب الصوم اللي نعيدها مرة أخرى الإسلام والعقل
that's true He said from the conditions of the obligations of fasting that the conditions is that which must exist before the fasting exists. Number one is you must be a Muslim. Number two, you must have sanity. And that you must And you must be of puberty.
الإسلام والعقل والبلوغ وعدم الحيض والنفاس
and the lack of menses and postpartum bleeding. These things must exist in able, to be able to fast. Again, is what? Help me, brothers. What is it?
Muslim.
Having sanity. Being at the age of puberty. And not having menses and postpartum bleeding. These things must not. These things must exist in order for a person to fast.
وكذلك من شروط وجوب الصوم الإقامة. أما المسافر فهو مرخص له.
As also from the شروط كذلك.
أيوة.
For the conditions of fasting is that a person must be a resident and not a traveler, because the traveling person is lifted from him fasting.
وكذلك عدم المرض. فالمريض معذور بترك الصوم.
And also included with that is lacking being sick, because the one who's too sick to fast, fasting is lifted from him.
قال تعالى فمن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخرى.
Allah Taala says in Baqarah that whoever is sick or upon traveling, then it's upon him to make it up on other days.
والمريض إذا كان مرضه دائما مستمرا لا يرجى زواله فهذا يكون حكمه حكم العاجز عن الصوم الذي تقدم ذكره.
He said as far as the person's sickness causes them to or a sickness that's permanent. There's no way out of that sickness. It's a permanent sickness. The verdict for them is like the verdict of the one who's not able to fast. Like we mentioned earlier. So what's upon them is the feet of person in other words.
إذا كان مرض مزمن مثل مرض القلب الشديد
If this sickness is a permanent sickness like having a sick heart or a weak heart
أو مرض السرطان عافانا الله وإياكم
Or having cancer and may Allah cure us and protect us from it
أو مرض الكبد الشديدة
Or having your liver the liver disease
ونحو ذلك من الأمراض
Or the likes of that
الشديدة أمراض شديدة.
From those severe sicknesses.
التي في العادة الطبية أنه لا يرجى برؤها.
That it is known in medicine that it's not possible to be cured from those sicknesses like that.
هؤلاء إذا كان يشق عليهم الصوم.
For those individuals, it's difficult for them to fast.
أو كانوا يحتاجون إلى الأدوية.
Or they in need of taking medicine in order to fast.
فهؤلاء يرخص لهم في الفطر.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made a concession for them of not fasting.
ويطعمون عن كل يوم مسكين.
And that they feed in place of that a poor person.
ولا قضاء عليهم.
And there's no making up of fasting for them.
لأنهم عاجزين عن الصوم.
Because they're incapable of fasting.
أما من كان مرضه مما يرجى زواله وبرؤه.
As for the person whose sickness will lead, is a sickness that they can be cured from, or they're going to get over one day.
فهذا يفطر.
That person breaks his fast.
ويقضي إذا عافاه الله عز وجل.
And he makes up the fast when he becomes healed or healthier.
وممن يرخص لهم في الفطر أيضا.
Also from what concession has been given for them also.
الحامل والمرضع.
Is the woman who is pregnant and breastfeeding.
لأن الحامل قد يشق عليها الصوم بسبب الحمل.
Because the pregnant woman perhaps fasting can be difficult upon her because of a pregnancy.
وكذلك المرضع قد يقل حليبها ويتأذى صغيرها بسبب الصوم.
And likewise the woman who's breastfeeding perhaps the fasting can cause her milk to decrease and be harmful. So upon lifted for her is the fasting also.
فهؤلاء فهاتان يجوز لهما الفطر.
For these two type of women, for them also is permissible for them to break their fast.
ويقضيان بعد ذلك.
And they both of them make it up later on after they come out of their pregnancy and breastfeeding.
ويجب على المسلم فيما يتعلق بقضاء رمضان أن يبادر إليه يبادر القضاء قبل رمضان الذي بعده.
From amongst the things that is upon the Muslims to do who have to make up the Ramadan is that they rush to try to do it before the next Ramadan come. You get that?
فلا يجوز له أن يؤخر صوم القضاء إلى ما بعد رمضان.
It's not permissible for him to delay making up his days to after the next Ramadan come.
ولهذا نذكر إخواننا الذين عليهم قضاء من رمضان الفائت أن يبادروا إليه ويقضوا ما فاتهم من الأيام.
For that reason, I encourage and incite my brothers who have to make up days from last Ramadan that they rush to do it now.
وهذا يستثنى منه حتى لو كان قبل رمضان بيوم واحد.
He said, "This is no exception, even to the point." If it's a day before the new Ramadan is about to start, and you got a date, make it up.
لأنه لا يجوز أن يتقدم المسلم رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين.
Often I made a mistake. The Sheikh says the only exception in this case is if it's the last days of Ramadan. They call it the Yom Hashek, the doubtful days, the last 2 days of the month of Sha'ban. That is not permissible for him to make it up at that time. If that be the case, it's not permissible because those are days of doubt that Ramadan may enter from.
جزاك الله خير. يمكن نحن بعد شددنا في ال...
لا أخطأت في الترجمة.
أنا عرف. ماشي. خلطنا الأمور عليك. معلش نعتذر. جزاك الله خير.
جزاك الله.
كذلك من المسائل المهمة في هذا الشهر الكريم أن يتحقق المسلم من غروب الشمس عند الإفطار حتى لا يفطر إلا وقد تحقق من غروب الشمس.
He said, from amongst the things that is upon the Muslim to make sure of and investigate is that he makes sure that the sun has set. He pays attention to that seriously.
ولهذا من أكل في الليل يظنه ليلا فبان فجرا فلا شيء عليه.
He said, because for example, if the person who has reached, he's eating, and he thinks that it's still nighttime and Fajr has come and he didn't know, but there's no sin against him in this case. He said, because the origin of this situation is that the night was remaining. And he's unable to make the determination that Fajr has come in.
فإذا تحقق من طلوع الفجر
that if he's certain and becomes a reality that the dawn has appeared
وجب عليه الإمساك
becomes obligatory at that point once he realized to refrain from eating and drinking
بخلاف غروب الشمس
which is the opposite case for the setting of the sun
فالأصل بقاء النهار
is that the origin of that is that the day has is remaining are you still in the day the state of daytime
فمن أكل أو شرب يظن الشمس قد غابت وهي لم تغب.
If this person eats and drinks and he thinks that the sun has set,
فعليه القضاء حتى لو كان مخطئاً.
That this person has to make up that day even if he does it by mistake.
كذلك أيها الإخوة الكرام من مسائل من أحكام هذا الشهر الكريم أن ثبوته لا يكون إلا بأحد أمرين.
He said that from amongst the important affairs, legal verdicts connected to the fasting that is obligatory for us to know about is making sure that we affirm and ascertain that the month of Ramadan has entered. And that's only done by two ways. The first one is by making sure you count the days of Sha'ban has become 30 days. If you know it has reached 30 days and it's the 30th day, you know the next day is Ramadan.
الثاني أن يرى هلال شهر رمضان.
The second way is that you see the crescent appear before your eye at nighttime.
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صوموا لرؤيته وافطروا لرؤيته.
The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, fast with seeing the crescent. And break your fast, meaning end the month of Ramadan, with witnessing the crescent.
فإن غم عليكم
and if it becomes cloudy upon you, not being because it's cloudy in the sky, you are unable to see the crescent.
فأكملوا عدة الشهر شعبان 30 يوما.
Then complete the month of Sha'ban as being 30 days, meaning let 30 days complete because you're not sure. So you let 30 days complete, then you know for certain tomorrow is going to be Ramadan.
ومن الآداب التي ينبغي للمسلم أن يفعلها تعجيل الفطر.
From amongst the affairs that is must and the etiquettes and mannerisms that the Muslims must adhere to is rushing to break your fast.
قال العلماء هذا من السنة لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطر.
The scholars of Islam says that this is something that's from Islam because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged by Islam because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the ummah will never cease being upon goodness as long as they rush to break their fast.
وأن يفطر على رطب فإن لم يتيسر فتمر فإن لم يتيسر حس حسوات من ماء.
That when it's time for you to rush and break your fast, that you break it with dates that are rutab, which are dates that's kind of hard, like almost like an apple. We don't see those dates here. Or with regular dates that we used to see, or with water.
في رطب موجود في كاليفورنيا انا
شفته. He said, Sheikh understood what I said. He said, no, I saw this rutab in California. He said, that's far from here.
لأن الشيخ كأنه قال إنه غير موجود رطب.
أنا عندنا النخل.
أيوة أنا رأيت رطب في بعض المحلات.
يعني أنا فيها
النخل. أيوة في المحلات الباكستانية وكذا.
يعني
وجدتها رطب يعني
مرسل. He just told the sheikh that we can't find rutab, but it's sent from other places at certain stores. You may be able to find it.
وهذا في حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يفطر على رطبات قبل أن يصلي.
He said there's a hadith that is narrated by Anas that he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to break his fast with rutab. Meaning?
يفطر على رطبات يعني.
No, بن كتب.
قبل أن يصلي.
He would break his fast with the rutab dates. Before he prayed the Salatul Maghrib.
فإن لم يكن فعلى تمرات.
And if he's unable to find that, then with regular dates.
فإن لم تكن حسى حسوات من ماء.
And if he didn't find dates, he would take a little portion of water.
انظروا يا إخواني قد يكون إفطار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أحيانا على ماء.
He said, look, my brother, sometimes the Prophet fast would be with breaking it with water.
خير خلق الله صلى الله.
And he's the best of creation of Allah, the best creation of Allah.
ونحن أحيانا يصيبنا يعني حزن أن لا نجد بعض الأطعمة الشهية.
And some of us, we feel sad and grieved if we can't find the food that we desire.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قد لا يجد لا رطبا ولا تمرا فيشرب ماء صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he wouldn't find the rutab dates, he wouldn't find the regular dates, and all he had was water to break his fast with.
هل ضره ذلك?
Did that harm him?
هو خير خلق الله.
And he's the best of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
نسأل الله أن يرحمنا وإياكم بواسع رحمته.
We ask Allah to show his mercy upon us and you, but shower upon us with his mercy. Amen.
والسنة للمسلم الصائم أن يحافظ على السحور.
He said, and from the sunnah of the Muslim that's fasting is to preserve his eating sahur.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, eat sahur for verily in it is blessings.
وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام فصل ما بين صيامنا وصيام أهل الكتاب أكلة السحور.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the thing that separates between us and the people of the book is the suhoor. The fasting between them and us is the suhoor.
وينبغي أن يؤخر السحور إلى آخر الليل.
It is permissible for him to delay the suhoor to the last portions of the night.
فهذا من رحمة الله بأهل الإسلام.
This is nothing more than the mercy of Allah to the people of Islam.
والحمد لله على هذه النعمة وعلى هذا التيسير يعني أن نأكل قبل طلوع الفجر سنة سنها نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم وأمر بها.
He said, and this is from the mercy and bounty of Allah upon us, is that we can eat and drink until the last moments, the last portions of the night.
ويكره للصائم المبالغة في الاستنشاق والمغمضة.
It is hated for the fasting person to be excessive in rinsing his nose and his mouth.
لقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وبالغ في الاستنشاق إلا أن تكون صائما.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, be excessive in rinsing your nose and mouth except for the one who's fasting.
فالاستنشاق في أثناء الوضوء سنة أن تبالغ فيه حتى تنظف أنفك وحتى تؤدي هذا الوضوء على السنة المحمدية.
He said that the point of this and the benefit of it is that the person be, you know, he go far reaching in rinsing his mouth and his nose to cleanse it out well following the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
لكن في نهار رمضان وأنت صائم لا تبالغ استنشق من غير مبالغة حتى لا يدخل ما في جوفك.
He said, and the point of not doing it while you're fasting in Ramadan or fasting period is that you don't be excessive or be far reaching with it, because perhaps the water will go inside of you and you swallow it.
ويكره ويحرم على الصائم السب والشتم واللعن.
And what is hated for the fasting person is to insult and curse people and do bad and do say evil things.
وهذا للصائم وغير الصائم لكن في حال الصوم أشد. هذا للصائم وغير الصائم.
This is the case for the fasting person and the person who's not fasting, but when fasting is more severe.
وكذلك ينبغي له أن يبتعد عن الأسباب التي تؤدي به إلى جماع زوجته فإن الجماع من أعظم المحرمات في الصوم.
He said from amongst the things that is important and must be avoided is doing the things that will lead to you having intercourse with your spouse. Avoid those things because intercourse with your spouse is the most prohibited thing to do while fasting.
فما يؤدي إلى الوقوع في الجماع من أسباب الوقوع في الحرام فينبغي له أن يجتنبه.
So anything that will lead to you falling into intercourse with your wife that you may do is a must that you avoid it and stay distant from it.
ويستحب للصائم السواك.
And it's recommended for the fasting person to use the tooth stick.
فإن السواك مطهرة للفم مرضاة للرب عز وجل.
Because the fasting is a purification for the mouth and is something that pleases the Lord.
هذه بعض الأشياء التي تتعلق بآداب الصيام وهناك مسائل أخرى كثيرة في حقيقة لكن يعني إذا كان عند بعضكم أسئلة أو استفسارات يمكن أن نذكر بعض ما يتعلق بأحكام الصوم من خلال أسئلتكم ونسأل الله جل وعلا أن يرزقنا وإياكم العلم النافع والعمل الصالح وأن يهدينا سواء السبيل وأن يجعلنا ممن صام هذا الشهر وقام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا وأن يجعلنا وإياكم فيه من المرحومين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
The Sheikh said that this is some of the verdicts, benefits and wisdom and virtues of the month of Ramadan that we mentioned. He said after that he made dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and have mercy on us and grant us to reach Ramadan and have a fasting month of standing and praying with believing in his obligation and seeking reward. And then he sent peace and blessings and prayers upon his prophet. And he said before that also, we'll leave the rest of the lecture for questions. If there are any questions, perhaps you'll get more stuff through your question. Su'al al-awwal, ma huwa bulugh? يعني كيف يبلغ الصبي. The first question, Sheikh, since you mentioned about the conditions as being in puberty, what is being in puberty?
نعم. علامات البلوغ ثلاث علامات.
That the signs of reaching puberty are three.
العلامة الأولى إنزال المني بشهوة.
That the first sign is a person having an orgasm out of desire for the first time.
والعلامة الثانية إنبات شعر العانة.
He said that the second sign is having hair on one's private parts.
والعلامة الثالثة بلوغ 15 سنة.
And the third sign is reaching the age of 15.
هذه علامات بلوغ الصبي وكذلك البنت.
He said, and likewise the girl. These are the how you reach puberty. He said, likewise the girl.
وتزيد البنت علامة رابعة وهي نزول دم الحيض.
He said what we add as an extra sign of reaching puberty in relation to the girl is her getting her menses for the first time.
فإذا جاء الحيض فقد بلغت.
That if her first menses come, then she has reached the age of puberty.
وهذا يجعلنا نهتم في أمر أبنائنا وبناتنا من جهة أحكام الصيام.
He said this shows us the importance of paying attention to our children and watching to see them reach the age of puberty.
فقد يبلغ الصبي وتبلغ البنت وأبوها لا يعلم بذلك وأمها تهمل صيامها.
And so what will happen, perhaps the child will reach the age of puberty and the father not knowing or the mother not knowing, and then next you know the mother and the parents become negligent in obligating that child to fast. So you must pay attention to this thing. JazakAllah. Okay. What should I do if I live in a community that start and stop Ramadan based on calculations? ماذا أسوأ ماذا ينبغي علي أن أفعل في مجتمع الذي يقضي أو يقوم بمعرفة رمضان بتقدير المعاصر الحساب أيضا؟
إذا كان المسلم في بلد غير إسلامي.
That if a Muslim is in a country that's not a Muslim country.
فإنه يعمل بأحد عدة علامات.
That is upon him to work by numerous means. Signs.
الأولى.
The first one.
أن يعمل برؤية أقرب بلد إسلامي يعمل بالرؤية الشرعية.
The first way is by him working by the nearest Muslim country who sight the moon.
كالمملكة العربية السعودية وبعض دول الخليج وبعض الدول العربية فإنها تعمل بالرؤية الشرعية.
He said for talk about Muslim countries that determine the sighting of the moon properly. I mean sighting of Ramadan properly. He said like Saudi Arabia or the Gulf states around it, or some of the other Arab countries who witnessed the month of Ramadan legislatively by seeing the crescent.
والعلامة الثانية التي يمكن للمسلم أن يعمل بها هي أن يرى بعض المسلمين الهلال في البلد الذي يقيم فيه.
From the second means or sign that he can use to determine the entering of Ramadan in this case is that some people in his country take the responsibility of looking to see the crescent for themselves.
فيعمل برؤيتهم.
And he implement what they witness, that they say they witness the moon. I mean the crescent, sorry.
وأما الحساب فلا عبرة به.
As far as using calculations, that there's no, we don't consider that whatsoever.
لأن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said,
الذي وصفه الله بقوله إن هو إلا وحي يوحى.
The one who Allah described him in the Quran as one who don't speak from his own vain desires.
والذي أنزل عليه القرآن هو الله رب العالمين.
And the one who descended upon him the Quran was Allah Azza wa Jal.
والله هو الذي خلق الشمس والقمر وخلق الخلق كلهم.
And Allah is the one who created the sun and the moon and all the creation.
ويعلم سبحانه وتعالى كل شيء.
And Allah knows all things.
ومع ذلك فقد ربط الشرع المطهر دخول الشهر برؤية الهلال.
So and along with that, the religion, this pure religion, has decided that the Ramadan is started with the sighting of the crescent for the month.
فقد جاء رجل عربي من أهل البادية إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال إني رأيت الهلال.
That a Bedouin came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, Verily I saw the crescent.
فصام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رمضان وأمر الناس بالصيام.
And the Messenger of Allah fasted the month of Ramadan and ordered the Muslims to fast.
وإذا لم يتيسر للمسلم هذا ولا هذا فيصوم مع المسلمين. يصوم مع المسلمين في هذا البلد المجتمع الذي هو فيه.
He said if none of these things that he mentioned is made easy for you to do, then you just fast with the Muslims of your country when they fast.
فإذا كان المسلمون مجتمعون وعندهم معرفة وعندهم اجتماع فينبغي لهم أن ينتدبوا من ينظر فيخرج غير الهلال.
He said it is upon the Muslims that have can gather and put themselves together that they go and have found someone who can go and see the crescent for themselves if they're able to do that.
فيعمل بهذا.
And they work by that.
No.
No. Yes. Should I take from the floor or read to do this first? Okay, inshallah. Last Ramadan, I traveled a lot. I missed so many days and feared making them up before this Ramadan came. Is it wajib, obligatory, to not fast when traveling for fear of not making it up in time or missing the 6 days of following Ramadan? Okay. Okay, it's a little confusing. Okay. يعني شيء صعب صعب شوية فهم السؤال. رمضان الماضي سافرت كثيرا وفاتني كثير من الأيام رمضان وخفت أن أقضيهن قبل مجيء رمضان التالي. إذن هل يجب علي أن لا أصوم وأنا في السفر مخافة أنني لا أقضيها أو أقضيها في وقتها قبل مجيء رمضان القادم؟ وكذلك هل ينبغي علي أن أقدم هذه يعني هذا القضاء قبل أن أصوم ستة أيام في الشوال؟
جمع ثلاثة أسئلة. لكن نقول يعني باختصار الصائم إذا سافر يجوز له أن يفطر ويشرع له أن يفطر.
He said it's permissible for the person. He said this question is comprised of three questions. He said first of all, the person who's traveling is permissible for him to break his fast, as we mentioned.
ولكن لو صام وهو مسافر.
But however, if he fasts while he's still traveling.
فصيامه صحيح.
His fasting is correct.
لكن إذا كان في مشقة عليه فلا ينبغي له.
But if he has very difficulty doing that, then it's not suitable for him to fast.
الأمر الثاني أنه يجب عليه أن يبادر بالقضاء طوال الأحد عشر شهرا.
He said, how, on top of that, it is a must for him to rush to the best of his ability to make up them days within those 12 months between the Ramadan.
لكن لا يجوز أن يؤخر حتى يدخل رمضان.
However, it's not permissible for him to delay it until the new Ramadan comes.
ولهذا المبادرة بالقضاء أفضل من التأخير.
He said, so rushing to make it up is way better than delaying it to make it up.
وأما صوم ستة أيام من شوال.
As far as fasting the 6 days of the month of Shawwal.
فهي سنة.
Then that is a sunnah.
لكن الفريضة أحب وأعظم عند الله عز وجل.
But however, making up that obligatory is more beloved and greater with Allah عز وجل.
فيقدم صيام الفريضة.
So he proceed making up the days of the obligatory fast.
ولو قدر أن الأيام استغرقت شهر شوال لأنه احتاج شهرا كاملا فإن الله يعطيه على قدر نيته.
He said even if that necessitates him to only make it up, if it's a lot of days, the whole month of the month of Sha'ban, Allah will reward that person on a degree of the month, in the month of Shawwal. I mean, if he has to make it up that whole month of Shawwal, shukran, the whole month of Shawwal, then Allah will reward that person for their intentions. The Sheikh said we'll take one more question. That one. Yes.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
My question is about my occupation. I travel several times during the week. My occupation, I travel several times during the week. Okay. Can I still be excused from fasting? And can I still fast while I'm traveling? More or less.
Okay.
My occupation, 4 times out of the week, I'm up early in the morning, I'm traveling.
Okay,
from New Jersey to Massachusetts and back.
طيب. يقول السائل سواء يتعلق بشغله وعمله أنه مسافر 4 أيام في الأسبوع. فهل يمكنني أن أصوم في ذلك أو أفطر؟ ويمكنني أن أصومها أو يجوز لي أن أفطرها؟ فماذا علي في هذا؟
إذا كان مقدار إقامتك في البلد الذي ستذهب إليه وهو ليس بلدك أكثر من 4 أيام فلا يجوز لك الفطر.
إذا كان أكثر
مثلا هو في نيويورك مثلا ويذهب إلى مثلا نقول واشنطن مثلا سفر طريق سفر فإذا كان إقامته في واشنطن مثلا 5 أيام 6 أيام أو أكثر فهذا لا يفطر إلا في طريق السفر أما في إذا نزل البلد فلا يفطر.
طيب. The Sheikh said if your traveling is happen to be more than 4 days that you don't break your fast while you're there. But the only time you break your fast is while traveling to that another state. He said, for example, if you're going from New York to Washington, traveling to from New York to Washington, you don't fast during that time. But if you're going to stay in New York or Washington, for example, for more than 4 days, you cannot break your fast while you're in Washington. You get that?
وأما إذا كان إقامته في البلد الآخر أقل أربعة أيام فأقل فهذا يعتبر مسافرا يحق له الفطر.
He said, as far as the place that you're traveling to, when you're in that country or that state or that city, if it's less than 4 days, like 3 days, he said, you don't have to fast while you're in that state.
وذلك أن هذه المسألة مرتبطة بضابط السفر.
He said, because this issue is that this individual is considered as a traveler. He's under the state of travel.
والذي عليه جمهور العلماء.
And that which a group of scholars are upon in regards to this issue.
أنه يحدد بأربعة أيام.
Is that he limits himself to 4 days.
وقال بعض العلماء إنه لا يحدد بمدة.
And some scholars do say he don't limit himself to no days.
فما دام في غير بلده فهو مسافر.
And they say, those other group, they say, as long as he outside of his country, he's outside of his city, he's a traveler.
إذا لم يعزم على الإقامة الدائمة فيه.
He said, as long as he's not going to be there for a long, for a long period of time.
لكن مثل ما قال شيخنا الشيخ عبد العزيز بن باز رحمه الله قول جمهور العلماء أحوط.
He said, but however, we go towards the position of our Shaykh, Shaykh Ibn Baz, Abdul Aziz Ibn Baz, is that the first group who says you should limit yourself to 4 days, this is a more cautious means than the other group. He said, this is a jumhur, this is the position of a large group of scholars, or the greater group of scholars.
You still have to make those days up though.
ولكن ما زال علي نقضي هذه الأيام يعني ده.
أيضا أفطر يقضي.
Of course, yes, you must make it up.
And even if I want to do it while I'm traveling, I can still do it. If I
well, يعني ولكن إذا أردت
أن
أسومها أستطيع. صح؟
نعم نعم.
Yes, you are.
أذكر إخواني.
I want to remind my brothers.
بأهمية التفقه في الدين.
The importance of y'all learning your religion.
وتعلم ماذا جاء في سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And to learn that which is coming to Sunnah of our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
حتى نعبد الله على بصيرة.
So that we can worship Allah upon clarity.
وتعلمون يا إخواني أن أهل الضلال والبدع ما ظلوا وابتدعوا إلا بسبب الجهل والعناد.
So realize with my brothers that the people of innovation and misguidance and desires and whims and desires, they didn't fall into their innovation and misguidance except because of ignorance.
ولهذا نقول اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
For that reason we say every day in the prayer, O Allah, guide us upon the straight path, the path of those whom you favor, and not the path of those who have your wrath and those who are astray.
فالمغضوب عليهم عبدوا الله فالمغضوب عليهم عاندوا وتركوا عبادة الله.
As far as the people who have the wrath of Allah, that's mentioned in this surah, is those people who renegade against the obedience of Allah and disobey Allah with knowledge. And the people who are astray are the people who worship Allah upon ignorance. The people who have the bounty upon them, as mentioned in this surah, are those who gather between knowledge and actions. Knowledge and actions.
في مثل هذه الأيام قبل سنة.
The likes of these days before a year ago,
تقريبا أعلن بعض الخوارج تنظيما لهم
that a group of the Khawarij had made an announcement of them formulating an organization.
فسموا أنفسهم دولة إسلامية
and they named themselves the Islamic government or Islamic state.
وهم ليسوا بدولة ولا بشيء.
He said they're not a country, a state, or anything.
لكن عندهم شبهات أظلوا بها بعض الشباب.
He said, but however, they have with them doubtful matters that they cause to lead astray much of the youth.
إذا لم نعالج هذه الشبهات قد يظل بعض الشباب إلى الآن.
He said, and if these doubts are not treated, then it will affect and lead astray the youth now.
فماذا فعلوا؟
So what did they do?
شوهوا صورة الإسلام.
They made repugnant the image of Islam.
وصاروا أشد على المسلمين من أعداء الإسلام.
And they became more harsh on Islam than the enemies of Islam.
بل هم ألد أعداء الإسلام.
He said, rather they are in reality the enemies of Islam.
ونحزن عندما نرى بعض الشباب الجهلة يلتحق بهم.
He said, and it saddens us when we see some of our youth join with them.
ويغتر بصنيعهم.
And they are deceived by their actions.
ولهذا جروا على المسلمين الويلات والفتن.
He said, for this reason, it has fallen upon, or the Muslims has been dragged into misguidance and corruption. And trials and tribulations. Thank you.
وهذا الإرهاب الذي يصنعونه.
And this terrorism that they do.
قد حذر العلماء منهم ومنه كثيرا جدا.
And our ulama has warned against it, their terrorism, and them abundantly.
وأصدر علماؤنا كثيرا من الفتاوى والتقريرات والبيانات في التحذير منهم ومن أفكارهم.
For that reason, many of our ulama have made an abundance of refutations and for legal verdicts and articles and established written things and tapes and so on and so forth, warning against these individuals.
فما على المسلم إلا أن يسأل ويتعلم.
So therefore, it's nothing upon the Muslim, it's upon the Muslims to strive hard to learn these things.
فليس من رفع راية الجهاد أو راية الإسلام يصدق في كلامه.
He said, cannot be accepted and looked as truthful that they raised in the banner of jihad.
بل يجب على المسلم أن يسأل أهل العلم الراسخين في العلم.
It is obligatory upon the Muslim to ask the ulama who deeply endowed and embedded in knowledge.
وأن يحذر من هذه الطوائف الضالة المنحرفة عن الإسلام.
And be cautious to stay away from these misguided groups from Islam.
أسأل الله جل وعلا أن يعيذنا وإياكم من مضلات الفتن.
We ask Allah to save us and you from the misleading trials and tribulations.
ونسأل الله أن يهدي ضال المسلمين ويردهم إلى صراط المستقيم.
We ask Allah to guide the misguided, the straying Muslim, and place them upon the straight path.
وجزاكم الله خيرا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.